Elon Musk and his SpaceX will soon be making the next big stride in advertising. It is advertisement in space. Yes, it may sound absurd, but we'll let you in on all the details, including what advertising in space is exactly and how Elon will manage to achieve it. But before that, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. Space commercialization has been a concept mused upon by industry experts and economists for decades now, ever since the acceleration of the development of space technology from the 2000s onwards. There were also previous concepts and general plan outlines for it during the height of the space race between the United States and the then Union of Soviet Socialist Republics. It is a concept that envisions the mass-scale use of outer space for promotional marketing and revenue-creating activities in outer space. For both sides, space commercialization would have served not only as a tool for bringing the international community into space with them for joint research and space activities, but also to further their political goals and keep a hold on technological advantages. Following the reduction of both countries' aerospace budgets from the 70s onwards and the eventual collapse of the USSR, however, such lofty plans were put to rest. They were not put to rest for long though, as the era of private aerospace companies in the 2000s and the gradual reinvestment in aerospace made by the world rekindled such a concept, albeit in a different form. Instead of governments leading space commercialization efforts themselves, private companies and corporations would do so with only background assistance from government actors. Advertising is one example of space commercialization, and with current aerospace technological capabilities, the starting point for the eventual normalization of corporate activities in space. There are many uncertainties attached to this, but many believe that advertisements on satellites will help produce breakthroughs and advancements. These very breakthroughs and advancements will later give other entrepreneurs the confidence required to make the jump into having their products advertised on satellites. Mass proliferation of aerospace technology and technological research spurred on by a large financial incentive for such research to be conducted could make our human civilization a true spacefaring civilization later on. Canada-based company Geometric Energy Corporation has been trying to convince SpaceX to begin work on an advertisement satellite project since at least early 2018. Elon Musk has recently announced the signing of an agreement between SpaceX and the Geometric Energy Corporation. The agreement was signed with a stated aim to, quote, bring space art to the moon. The meaning of space art is rather clear. They want to put up a large space for advertisements and other visuals on a screen attached to a satellite. Design descriptions of the satellite that will be sent up indicates a modification of a design known as CubeSat with a large screen intended for any desired advertisement or visual. It will be launched on SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket. Opportunity for advertisement won't be limited just to SpaceX or any of their business partners. Of course, they plan to make good money out of such a lucrative advertisement space, so it can be won by any company or individual able to last in a bidding process. Indeed, there will be many among those who want to become the first cosmic promoters in history. Perhaps quite predictably, Elon Musk, in his characteristic maverick personality and flamboyance, also opened the possibility for individuals to be able to buy ad space through cryptocurrency. Reports also indicate that there will be a separate body set up to carefully analyse and process the advertised content, as due to the open nature of the bidding process, they want to be aware of inappropriate joke advertisements in the same vein as internet memes. It remains to be seen what the bidding scene will truly look like as a billboard advertisement in a major American or European sets companies back an average of $923,000 to have it up for a month. Some countries even charge extra cost on top of the principal for advertising. Geometric Energy Corporation CEO Samuel Reed has stated they want to take a, quote, democratic approach to advertisement. As part of this, their and SpaceX's space advertisement sales are organized in the form of selling pixel space. There are five different tokens to bid for corresponding to specifications named after Greek letters. These are Gamma, Kappa, Beta, Rho, and Chi. Further questions about this compartmentalized token system are unanswered, although it is known to be fact that these tokens determine aspects such as brightness, color, X and Y coordinates, and advertisement running times. It can be said with certainty that the final process for paying customers will not be so complex at all. We can expect to see extremely competitive bidding, and we should not be surprised at all if the bid figures push into the tens of millions of dollars. The first CubeSat space billboard is expected to launch next year. This is especially ambitious since the engineers at Geometric Energy Corporation are still working on a quantum communication system that will make billboard advertising possible with data beamed up from Earth. For SpaceX, though, it will be fine, as despite certain unresolved issues with their launch systems, they can handle small payloads without much trouble at all. Despite the fact that this will be another major achievement for Elon Musk and the aerospace and marketing industries combined, we have to keep in mind the detractors and critics of this venture. We cannot truly deny that those critics speak with merit when they speak of the possible environmental consequences of putting a billboard in space. The world is already dealing with the issues posed by space debris. Bits and pieces of old satellites have been falling off and floating in space. These debris often cause other damages, and some even fall to the Earth. Starlink, another one of SpaceX's ventures, will involve at least 10,000 satellites orbiting in space, and experts assert that a dense ring of space debris may soon be formed around Earth. There is also an ethical concern tied to commercializing yet another natural space of existence for monetary gain. What would a floating advertisement in space really look like? Would it be tasteful? These are important questions to consider, and we can expect many people to take outright offense to this initiative. People will also be concerned about the sort of example this will be setting for further enterprises looking to send space billboards up and the overall future of a commercialized outer space. Maybe it would be for the best that we keep private corporations away from molding outer space the way they see fit. We know for a fact what happens when private corporations are allowed to do what they will without much regulation and oversight. Clearly, one of the main causes of mass pollution in many places around the world has been lack of oversight and care for the environment. On the contrary, it would be a fool's pursuit to assert that a wholly government-owned and directed effort at space would be free from any long-term damage to near-Earth outer space. After all, the overall goals for any venture are shared between a typical corporation and a government. The need to make money drives much of the work. For Elon Musk, the successful completion of this project will serve as a major marketing boost for himself and his ventures SpaceX and Tesla. This is perhaps the greatest marketing stunt to be made in recent times, and it will drive up contracts and funding for SpaceX's projects. They will certainly appreciate extra help and resources in the development of the Starship, which seems to be lagging slightly behind. The very future of SpaceX as an aerospace company and the rest of the aerospace industry is wholly pinned on the success of the Starship design. Thus, this is probably what drove SpaceX and Elon Musk to take up the offer from Geometric Energy Corporation and launch this project. As for the GEC themselves, we can expect to see further cooperation and collaboration between GEC and SpaceX, or even Tesla, as Elon Musk prefers working with reliable partners. What do you think of this initiative by Elon Musk? It is a fascinating concept, but do you find yourself appreciating it fully? Do you agree with its critics in regards to ethics and space debris? Or do you think it will lead us to a more enlightened future? Or further yet, do you think it is simply a wasteful publicity stunt? Let us know in the comments below. If you like this video, you may also enjoy this next video on how Elon Musk learns 10 times faster than anyone, that is shown in the end screen. See you there.